Hi everyone, here is Timmy and today I have prepared for you a review. And that is the review of Twisted Gift, the sequel to Twisted Fate. You can watch my video about Twisted Fate, why I love it very much. And today I am going to review the new book because it has been released this week on the 21st of September, and you should go and buy it because it is a really good book, and buy the first book too, and because Jessi Elliott knows how to write a good romance. And today's video, it is going to be a free part because in the first part of the video I am going to talk about the cons, which I did not like so much. And the second part will be the pros, which I loved very much. And at the end, I will tell a few things overall what I think about the book. And I've got an arc for an honest review, so this is based on my own opinions and what I think about the book, and that it's all. So let's start. I will start with the first con, which I do not like that much. That is, oh, and spoiler alert, please, if you do not want to know anything about the books, go read them and after that you can watch my video, because there will be spoiler alert, spoilers of the book. So this video is with spoilers. Do not watch further if you do not want to know anything about the storyline. So the first con is that I had a perception of fairies, and in this book it is approached a little differently, and it is a little bit similar to vampires, which I do not really like. And there are a lot of references and there are a lot of similarities between the fairies and the vampires. Like the words feeding, hungry, and iron stakes through heart, so they die if they get a iron stake pushed through their heart. Does it sound familiar? Yeah, vampires die a little bit the same. So, and as a psychologist, I heard, and there is a concept that there are humans who are called energetic vampires because they complain so much and they are full of negative thoughts and full of negative behavior, and they suck really out the energy of people, and those are called energetic vampires. And in this book, the fae sounded exactly like energetic vampires because they feed on the emotions of people. So yeah. And I will read a few quotes from the book that yes, this is from one of the Aurora, the main character, said, "It stems from this deep-rooted fear I have that I lose control while feeding and won't be able to stop." Yeah. If you didn't know anything about the book and you would read only this line, I bet that most people would think that it is a vampire story and not about fairies. So yeah, and another one after that, the human exists in an in-between stage. They're alive barely and they need human emotions, energy to complete the process. Once that's done, voila, a fair is made. Isn't this similar to the Twilight series? Yeah, because there Bella had to turn and she was human for a time, and after that the poison turned her. Yeah, here too, the poison, the fairy poison, turns people to fairies, fairies, sorry. And yeah, so this is the biggest con, and sometimes it disturbed me, but there weren't, fortunately, so many scenes about feeding, so it did not disturb me that I wanted to put down the book or something. But yeah, and there is another thing, which is the next con, that I found really funny. That why would someone say something like this? I'm not going to last long. This is in a love scene when they make love. And I do not understand, especially if he is a freaking magical creature, why cannot he do it for longer time? So I this confused me a little, because I understand humans, but he's a freaking fair. So why? Okay, let's go further. Please, these are the cons, and I am telling you that the cons are shorter and less than the pros. So please listen till the end. And yeah, there were a few scenes that spoiler alert again, when Aurora was captured. It was a really, really long chapter, and repeating things, it was a little boring for me, and I would have loved if it would have been shorter, or to change the point of view to Tristan and see what he feels and how he searches for Aurora, and I would have been interested more of his point of view instead of all the stuff why she was captured, because let's face it, it was too much for me, at least. Yeah. And this is a little confusing thing for me, at least, because I watched the TV show Gilmore Girls, and there one of the main characters is Rory, and while reading the nickname of Aurora, Rory, every time I was taken out of the story, because I was reminded of another thing, and that was a little bit of a bum, but it isn't a big con. Yes. And another thing that a little bit disturbed me, that there was more cursing than in the first book, and it did not disturb me so much, but it stopped the story for a few seconds, and I had to re-enter the story so that I can continue, because it doesn't disturb me if there are, let's say, 10-20 cursing in a book, but when it is more, well, yeah. I know this is a new adult, but even if it is a new adult romance book, it shouldn't contain so many cursing, in my opinion. So these were all the cons. Please, are you still here? I hope that you are, because now comes the fun part, the positive, the pros that I loved very, very, very much. So let's start. Of course, the biggest pro in the book is the romance. It is very well developed, in my opinion. I love very much the couple Aurora and Tristan and their love. There are a few quotes that I wrote out and underlined in the ebook because I love it very much. I am just looking for it. So, and it is really beautiful. I love it how it is done. I think that Jessi did a really good job with the romance. Oh God, I've missed that, the way he looks at me as if I'm the only other person in the world. Wouldn't you want to feel this when a man looks at you or your partner or what preferences you have and you feel like this? I would really love. He's always given me strength. I think that is really important, that in a relationship the other uplifts you and gives you strength to continue. We stay like that for several beats before he turns his hand over and slips his fingers through mine. Isn't this so romantic? I love so much. I love it. We don't give up on each other. I agree. This is a longer one. I shoot him a look and he smiles. I need to get dressed, I say instead of responding. Of course, he says, but makes no move to leave the room. I almost smile. I can manage on my own. Amusement flashes across his face. You sure? I mentally zip my lips before I go and do something stupid like invite him to stay, to forget about the party and about keeping this professional. Tristan, I say softly, I'll be downstairs in a few minutes. This is so intense, at least for me, this scene. Wow, it is funny, intense and exciting and everything. And this is how about Max's feelings. He loves him. I recognize that look. It's the way I look at Tristan. I can feel him behind me and the urge to drop what I'm holding, turn around and kiss the crap out of him is overwhelming. At the Westbrook Hotel, we're barely in the elevator 5 seconds before our lips are locked, fighting for control as we grasp at each other desperately. I've never felt a need so strong. The only way to describe this feeling, this exchange between two people who have lived without each other for too long, is a lust-filled frenzy. So, do you like it? I like it. I like it very much. Oh, and the favorite part, that the love scene, the love making, it is sooner than in the first book and it is longer with a lot of hot things. Oh, yes. Oh, this is one of the best. Christ, Rory, you're everything. He tips my face up slightly. Everything. Wouldn't you want to hear this from someone? Yes. I love the lovemaking scene very much. It is a perfect balance. Just my style. I want to be with you forever, Aurora. There will never be a day, hell, a moment, that I won't love you, respect you, cherish you. I want to heal with you, grow with you, make new memories with you. Oh my God, I am melting. I love it very much. This is a lot, I know. I love you with every part of me. And if you'll do me the incredible honor of spending your life with me, I will continue to love and care for you until our final day together on this earth. This is so romantic. I love Tristan so much. Tristan is... I think I am falling in love with him. Yes. Yeah. And let's go on because the time is ticking as I see. Oh, and the other relationship in this book, the friendship between Aurora and Allison, I love it very much. They are the perfect friendship, in my opinion. They help each other, they are there for each other, and I love it. Yeah. Oh, and the next one is that I love the style of speech of Aurora. It really is in the style of new adults, so it is really good. Let's read a few of that, how she talks. Yeah, where the cursing, she says fuck a little bit too much. Yeah, another cursing. Yes, I love that she is so genuine. She is showing her emotions and she acts about them. So, and she's so funny. She's today is not going to be ruined by my epically failing fairness. It's a sad moment. Carbs are my favorite. The thought of him still makes my chest ache, as if someone poured concrete into my lungs. Yeah. I can control myself. Just because of what I want him doesn't mean I can't be in a room with him without thinking about fucking him on the top of the park. This is, what is this? 50 Shades of Fair? Forget it. I love it so much. And I love it that she's so anxious, but so genuine. The struggle of Aurora, it is described so beautifully and so believable. I love it very much. And I love it that Aurora is very kind and thoughtful. She thinks about others. The last thing he deserves is the weight of the consequences of my actions on his shoulders. How sweet. They've worked as hard as I have and they deserve to celebrate their success. He doesn't know what's going on in my life, but he didn't deserve my short temper. Fuck, I should clean it up before it ruins the wood. So yes. She thinks about others. Oh, and the other thing that I love, in quotes, she has balls. She's so witty. She's courageous because she goes into the bar even she's scared. So yeah, and she confronts Nikolai for feeding on his fans and shit, I'll take my chances. So I love it very much. She's starting to become one of my favorite main characters. So Aurora is really nice. Yes. And I The next pro is that I love the world building. It's really interesting world that Jessi built, and the color emotions, I love it, that the color system, I love it very much, as I told you already in my review of Evelyn's number, that the color system, I love colors, and here too it is used, the colors, and I love it, and the first person, I prefer books in the first person, so I love it very much. And the formatting, I love how the covers look. They are in the on the first book and the second, both book covers are really amazing. I love them very much. And what I love in both books are the font of the chapters. It is really beautiful, so curly. I love beautiful style. And of course, the last thing, the last pro is Jessi's writing style. I love her writing style very much. I got sucked in very much in the story. I couldn't put down the book. I loved it so much. It is really amazing. And the ending, oh my god, is the best ending ever. I mean, yeah. And it is a really good balance between showing and telling. I love it how Jessi managed it. And it really fits in the new adult category. So I love new adult category. So yeah. And I didn't think that I will cry, but I cried when Max, yeah. So let's talk about overall book. I loved it very much. I am giving it 4 stars, and that is only because I loved Twisted Fate more. Twisted Gift was good, it was more exciting until the capture. After the capture, I don't know, it dragged a little bit for me, so that is why these are the two reasons that I am giving only 4 stars and not 5, but I loved it very much. I recommend it. Go buy it, go read it, because it is really good. And I wasn't surprised that the bad guys are humans, because yeah, sad but true. So this was my review of Twisted Gift. I hope you liked it. Do not forget to watch my interview with Jessi about her writings. And please leave your questions for the Q&A. I mean, there will be a Q&A in 2 days, I wanted to say. You can still leave your questions and they will be answered in the next Q&A. Yeah. So I hope you like this video, and if yes, then please give me a thumbs up. And that's all for today. I wish you all the best. Have a blessed day, everyone.